Namaste viewers, welcome to Jnana Degula channel. Today we will go through the story of Vyasa, then Mahabharata being written by Ganesha. It's a quite an interesting story. We'll go through the story. Before we go to the story, I request you to please like, share and then subscribe to my channel. The story goes like this. Long, long ago, there were a lot of during those age, great sages, lot of great epics that took place, like Mahabharata, Ramayana, so many things happened. During one of those periods, a sage by name Vyasa was there. He was a very wise and enlightened human, enlightened seer. He had witnessed a lot of rise and fall of kings, the struggles during those days for the sake of Dharma by these kings, the great wars, and particularly the great war of Kurukshetra, that is Mahabharata. So he had witnessed all these many stories, many history he had seen. This Vyasa was blessed with divine knowledge. He is said to have composed lot of like Sanskrit texts, all those things, and he wanted to compose this grand narration, grand story of the Mahabharata. He had conceptualized in his mind. This story carried the wisdom of life, the relationship, complexities of relationships, and of course the struggle, ever struggle between good and then bad, good, evil, like this. So many things were there in his mind, and he had everything in his memory, but there was one problem. This particularly the Mahabharata was not an ordinary story. It was very vast, very vast, very intricate in its like history, story in story, like this, and it was filled with lot of profound teachings. So writing it down was not an easy task. Vedavyasa wanted somebody to write down this. He wanted this epic to reach to all corners of the world, like, you know, he wanted to ensure that it reached everybody. But he also knew that writing it himself would take too long, probably because of his age and other things, you know, it would take a longer time to write. His heart was restless, and he wondered how he could accomplish this great task of writing it down. Now he keeps discussing wherever he goes, wherever he meets people, wherever he meets great souls and things like that. On one occasion, Vyasa was talking to Lord Brahma, and he expressed his desire to write this, and then he asked his suggestion. Lord Brahma, he came in front of him. Lord Brahma is none other than the creator of the universe. He appeared before him with a warm smile for the question of this Vyasa's worry. You know, Brahma said, Vyasa, Vedavyas, your epic, your history which you are writing is destined to illuminate the world. It's going to be a very great masterpiece. It will guide generations to follow whatever that is written here. But for such an extraordinary task, I understand that you need an extraordinary help. So immediately Vedavyasa very humbly requested Lord Brahma, who could help me, my Lord? He asked him. Brahma immediately replied, call upon Ganesha. You please go and then meet Ganesha. Ganesha is none other than the great God. He is the remover of obstacles, who removes obstacles. He is a God of great wisdom, knowledge, learning. His presence, your association with him will ensure a very smooth and then complete of your work, completion of your work, he said. So Vedavyasa, the writer of Mahabharata, was inspired by Brahma's advice. Immediately he meditated upon Lord Ganesha with a very pure heart, requesting his assistance. So now, no sooner Vedavyasa requested him, called out to Lord Ganesha. Lord Ganesha appears, his radiant form glowing with divine energy. His elephant head symbolizing wisdom and his calm demeanor radiated peace. Ganesha appears before Vyasa. He greeted Vedavyasa and said, oh Vyasa. He knows everything, Ganesha, being a god, and then he knows he can read everybody's mind. He had already understood. He says, oh Vyasa Maharaja, Vyasa, I know why you have called me. I am here to assist you. You don't worry. Whatever you need, I will do it. Now Vyasa again, he explains, I have composed in my mind a great epic. I want to call it as Mahabharata. It mainly contains the history and stories of humanity, dharma, destiny, all these things. But it is too vast, very, very large for me to write alone. And then he requests his help to write it down. Lord Ganesha immediately agreed, but he placed a condition. He said, I will write for you, don't worry. But you must not stop, you must not pause while narrating. If you stop, I will leave, he said. He says, you should continuously keep dictating me without any stop, non-stop you should dictate to me. I will write it down. If you stop, I will also stop and then leave. So now Vyasa was also, he was also wise. He agreed to his condition, but he immediately thought and then added his own condition. Vyasa also puts a condition to Lord Ganesha. Whatever I say, you must understand every word and every verse before you write it down. He puts this condition. Because understanding, writing is one thing, understanding whatever you say and then writing is a little different. It takes a little more time. So this way Vyasa bought some time to narrate so that he would have more time. Ganesha immediately smiled, recognizing the cleverness of Vedavyasa's condition. So now both of them, they agreed, and then the two, they begin their divine collaboration, they begin their work. This writing starts as Sri Sri Vyasa started narrating the Mahabharata. Ganesha, Lord Ganesha, wrote with unmatched speed. Very swiftly he starts writing his, writing whatever he says. His pen moved like lightning, you know, like this, capturing every word. But Vedavyasa, anticipating the challenge, would occasionally recite verses so complex, that Ganesha had to think a while and then reflect on their meaning, then start writing. These thinking for a while, pausing for a while and reflect on their meaning and then writing, these moments gave Vyasa the time he needed to compose the next part of the story in his mind, whatever he wanted was the next part of this epic in his mind. This unique partnership between wisdom and intellect ensured that the Mahabharata was written without any mistake, flawlessly and with great care. Now there is always a question, why Ganesha? Many people wonder why Vyasa chose Ganesha for his task. Of course, Lord Ganesha was suggested by Lord Brahma. The answer lies in Ganesha's nature itself. He is the remover of obstacles, the god of knowledge and learning, and guardian of the sacred texts. All these qualities are there with Ganesha. No one else could have written the Mahabharata as swiftly, as flawlessly, as easily as Ganesha. His presence also ensured that the work was imbued and it would carry some divine blessings. Now, with Ganesha's help, the Mahabharata was completed, and this masterpiece, Mahabharata, becomes a timeless treasure for humanity. Even to this day, there is no other book larger than this Mahabharata. And its teachings on dharma, devotion, destiny, all these continue to guide people even today. Here you find Bhagavad Gita is a part of this Mahabharata also. So many things are there. Bhagavad Gita is, even to this day, it's one of the greatest guide to humanity. The story of Vedavyas, who narrated this story, and Ganesha, who wrote all these things, all this reminds us of the importance of collaboration. If two, three people join together, then the collaboration, the wisdom and the divine grace that aids great endeavors, you can achieve greater things, greater goals. So now, viewers, and when you hear the name of Ganesha, you remember how his wisdom and dedication helped bring this Mahabharata to life, which spread light and knowledge across the world. This is the story of the Mahabharata being written by Lord Ganesha, dictated by Vedavyasa. With this, we will end this story, small story. I hope this story is quite interesting, and then worthy of reading, listening. Please listen to the story. Please like, share and then subscribe to my channel, and post your comments in the comment box. For the benefit of the readers, I have put the story in the description box. Thank you, viewers.